Hello Sagittarians, welcome to my channel Surabhi, and this is the reading for you and your person. So on one side will be your energies, on other side will be the energies of the person you are dealing with, and then the most likely outcome. And please feel free to swap the characters according to your situation. Let's see what's there for Sagittarians. So on your side we have the Two of Pentacles, trying to make up your mind, being indecisive over something or juggling over something. On your person side we have the Moon. Okay, things not very clear, don't know what to do, just follow your instincts, just to do what you feel is right for you. Most likely outcome, the Chariot. Wow, things moving pretty fast, taking control and action. Okay, so let's see. Why is this Two of Pentacles here for? Okay, we have the Hermit. We have the Hermit, the Seven of Wands, and the Three of Cups on your side for the Moon. On your person side we have, okay, the Hangman, the Ten of Cups, and the Nine of Cups. Okay, what is this Chariot here for? Okay, we have the Lovers, the Eight of Swords, and the Ten of Wheels. And again, just saw the fourth card, that is again the Chariot. Okay, let's take it. I feel like taking, I'll take them. Justice and the King of Wands. Okay, so let's proceed. So here for the Two of Pentacles we have the Hermit, the Seven of Wands, and the Three of Cups. So what I feel is you are juggling over something, trying to make up your mind, trying to decide as to what to do, what not to do, perhaps regarding this relationship. Okay, and for that, with the Hermit, you are taking time off, you are sort of isolating yourself, in the sense that you're just thinking about it, prodding about it, being in touch with your intuition, listening to your inner voice, that as, do you really want this relationship? Do you really want a relationship? Whatever it is. So whatever it is you're trying to juggle about, whatever you are trying to make up your mind on, you are just taking that time off and actually trying to contemplate over everything. And I think it's a beautiful thing to do. You really should know what you want. Okay, and what I feel here is, suddenly I'm being drawn to these bright spots, and what I feel is you feel enlightened in some way. It is a stepwise enlightenment of either your own self, either your own energy, maybe some sort of spirituality is attached to it, or maybe it is soul upliftment, whatever it is, but it is stepwise elevation of something, stepwise enlightenment, acknowledgement. I should say stepwise enlightenment is the beautiful word. Maybe you're the person who prays a lot or meditates a lot, maybe that is what it is, but it's about your higher self. It's talking about your higher self, enlightenment of a higher self. You really know what you want. You are in a beautiful energy. You are very self-confident. You know what it is. You can see in and out of the things, and highly spiritually enlightened. And that is what you've achieved slowly and slowly, stepwise. So you are, or maybe you're on that path. Maybe you're already on that path. It can be that also. Okay. So, but that is what you are doing. You are trying to take a decision with the Seven of Wands. You are definitely contemplating on what it is, trying to make up your mind, trying to take a decision. Okay, but I don't think that you've actually taken any decision over here. Following it is a Three of Cups, which talks about perhaps discussing with your friends or your close people, whosoever your trustworthy people are. So here, this is, you are trying to make up your mind, basically trying to take a decision over here, And here we have the moon card. This person is also not very clear. Things are, we have, for that we have the hangman, the 10 of cups and the 9 of cups. So things are stuck, things are not moving forward. We have the 10 of cups and the 9 of cups. So what I feel here is, things are not very clear in the mind of this person also. Perhaps they are using their intuition. Things are stuck for some reason. Things are not progressing. The relationship is not progressing. But with the 10 of cups and the 9 of cups, this person sees you as a wish fulfillment. They want to have a family with you. They want stability with you. Okay, but what I feel here is, things are stuck. Perhaps you have not made up your mind because of that. It can be this also. Okay, and that is why they really don't know what to do. This person is not very clear as to what's going on, what will be the outcome, because they want a family. Things are stuck because you are indecisive. Okay. And the outcome is the chariot. So being in control, taking a decision, things moving forward. For that we have the lovers, the 8 of swords and the 10 of wheels. So definitely it is a passionate connection. There is love in this connection and it's a strong bond. The only thing is, with the 8 of swords, some sort of reluctancy is in moving forward. Something is holding you back or holding them back, whosoever. It is, something is holding this relationship back. But since it is a very passionate connection, there is a lot of love, there is a lot of passion, a lot of connection over here. With the 10 of wheels, things will move forward. Things will definitely move forward with this. That is clarified with the chariot also. So things will get rolling. And again here, as I said, we had the chariot, the justice and the king of wands. So definitely things will be balanced. Things will move. And when they will move pretty fast also. And they will move in a balanced way also. So that fast will not, perhaps may not be that you're rushing in. But yes, it is a beautiful balancing energy. And all these three major cards are there. So what I feel is, this relationship is bound to happen. It is just the time being that this person with 8 of swords over here, somebody, you, I think, because this is a person who is taking a lot of time to decide. It's coming on your side, can be them also. This is a person taking a lot of time to decide because there is something which is holding them back, and that something is major. Okay, for them, it's tough for them to come out of it. Okay, and that is why maybe this was the aspect of their life which had led them to the path of spirituality also, because somehow I am getting that vibe from the Hermit card. It is not only about being just trying to take a decision, taking a time off. No, it is about that spiritual enlightenment. This is a person whose soul is quite uplifted. That's what I'm getting. A beautiful soul, very mature, very enlightened, very, very pious soul perhaps. A beautiful soul over here, Sagittarians. Beautiful energy. Okay, but then yes, though the things are not moving forward now, but they will definitely. And things will, once they start rolling, they will move beautifully. There is a lot of passion ultimately in this relationship. Things will be balanced and you will feel happy in this relationship. The guidance from the universe, be supportive. Number 45 or number 9 may be of some significance. Be supportive. Make a genuine effort to show that you care. So in this, the only thing is, be supportive. This, just need to open up. Just need to show the support to each other. This is your card, Sagittarius. Just see, just by chance, today I just had a look at it. The way, just you can see the arch over here. Okay, so it's your card actually. Just be supportive to each other. And I think once you are out of this indecisiveness and things are clear to the other person, you have got your own card. Just be supportive to each other and it is a beautiful connection. That's what I feel. It's your card and the way they are clinging to each other and the way it's a positive thing. It's looking like a pure soulmate, an angelic connection. That's what I said. This is somebody who is a very, very pious soul. A beautiful soul you're connecting with, whosoever it is. Sagittarians, it's on your side, so it has to be you, I guess. So that's all I have for you, Sagittarians. Hope it helps. And please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And let's meet in the next video. Bye.